meeting will be as follows. I will mute everyone in the audience except Mr. Pandit Roy. Mr. Pandit Roy will make his presentation. After we listen to him, we can ask our questions. You can ask your questions by typing your questions in the chat box, or you can also email me at ed@agricultureinformation.com. I repeat, ed@agricultureinformation.com. And I'll be forwarding those questions to Mr. Pandit Roy and he'll answer them. And if we have time, I may unmute 1 to 2 members in the audience and you can directly talk to Mr. Pandit Roy. Mr. Pandit Roy, I'm unmuting you and you can start your session now.
Is a software engineer. After my Mr. career, Pandit, I started my agriculture. Yes?
Yeah. One second. Yeah, you can start now.
Okay. So, I started my agriculture mainly on forestry planting, teaks, red sanders, and sandalwood. These are the planting we do here, and we do the nursery of sandalwood. So I can give you a few points starting from the how to germinate the sandal and nursery and planting the sandal. So the sandal is now I start how to collecting the seeds. Seeds mainly you have to collect from the government sources. And these seeds, if you has to be collected in recently, if it is very old, 1 year, something like that, there will be a germination problem. And if you collect from the government sources, it will germinate properly. And the seeds must have been collected from the good trees, good example trees and plus trees it is called. Once you collect the seeds from them, you can sow it in the sand bed. Sand bed has to be in around 1/2 feet height, and in the sand bed you can sow the seed. Before sowing the seed, you have to apply gibberellic acid for 16 hours. Then only it will give a good germination. So after that, it will start germinate from 25 days to 60 days. The seeds are germinated from 25 days to 45 days are very good saplings. Once the saplings come with the 2 leaf, you have to transplant into the poly bag. Poly bag has to be mixed with the soil, red soil and leaf manure or backyard manure. Once it is transplanted to the poly bag, you have to apply fungicides. Fungicides, for example, Indofil M5 or Ridomil Syngenta. This has to be applied every month. After transplanting into the poly bag, you have to sow one host seed. The first seed is the red gram. Usually the red gram is very suitable for the sandalwood horse seed. This sandal sapling will make connection to the host plant, take the nutrition from the host plant. So the host plant is very important. Not like other plants, the sandal is a semi-parasite, which can connect to the other plant roots and take the nutrition from there. That is very important. If there is no host plant, after some time this sandal plant will die. After 6 months, when it is grown for 1 feet height, you can plant it in the field. When you plant it in the field, the sandalwood, you have to plant it in 4 meter by 4 meter. In center, you have to plant the sandalwood sapling. In 4 corners, you can plant any saplings like casuarina, red sander, or melia dubia, rosewood. These are some of the plants which can act as a host for a longer period, like 10 to 15 years. So though these plants are there, you have to some threats. You have to sow some small plants like casuarina nearby the sandalwood, so that it will connect to that plant and take the nutrition from there. If the host plant is not properly planted, after 1 or 2 years, these sandalwood seeds, sandalwood saplings will die. So that is very important. In the sandalwood, after 6 to 7 years, you have to stop watering and has to give the stress to the plant so that the hardwood will start forming. In the sandalwood, there are two types of wood. One is the hardwood, which is formed in the center of the tree, and the sapwood. The hardwood is the economic one. 1 kg is sold in the current market is 6 to 7,000 rupees, and the sapwood is sold for around 1,200 rupees. So after 15 to 18 years, you can harvest the plants. And if you want to continue, you can continue to get more revenue. After 17 years, each tree will produce 25 kg of hardwood and more than 100 kg, more than 50 kg of sapwood. So this can be sold to the government agencies. The government agencies will come and cut the tree and take them. So these sandalwood trees cannot be sold in the outside market directly. So you have to inform the forest department in locally in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, most of the South Indian states have the policy, and they will come and cut and they take a 20% of the revenue, and 80% will be paid to them. So the government allows to plant the sandalwood trees in private lands, and there is no issue, legal issues to plant that. Rajini? Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Can you hear me? Yeah, can you hear me?
Rajini, are you? I am able to hear.
Okay.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, we are able to hear you.
Okay, I gave most of the important things, starting from nursery to harvest. If anyone has the questions, you can raise me.
Okay. Audience, you can start your questions. Mr. Brijesh, Kachendra, Kumar. Okay, Pavitra has one question. Is it possible to harvest sandalwood in 15 years? As we heard, it takes around 35 to 40 years.
The sandalwood start forming the hardwood from the 60 years onwards. On 15th years, it can be harvested, 15 years and above. If they wait for 20 years or 25 years, they will get more return. And it is not, it is a myth that it can be harvested only on 35 to 40 years. In the forest situation, maybe it takes 30 to 40 years because it doesn't get a proper host plant, it doesn't get a nutrition, it doesn't get a water. In silviculture, it can be harvested in 15 years.
Okay. Mr. Kajendra,
soil condition.
Yeah.
The soil condition, any soil condition is suitable except black cotton soils. Since the black cotton soils will give a gap in the summers and everything, this plant is not suitable only for that. It can be planted in the sand, on red soil, in stony areas. Stony areas is very suitable for the sandal, and it will give a very good hardwood in the stony areas.
Okay.
Okay.
Mr. Satish? And rest of the audience, you can continue your questions. Mr. Prashant, Satish. Dr. Malik. Okay. Kavita has question. Do you provide consultancy with buyback arrangement?
We can provide a consultancy starting from nursery and planting, all these. This buyback arrangement we cannot make because the buyback is not possible. And the government is restricting to sell the wood to the open market. So we can sell the sandalwood only to the government agencies. Few government agencies are there, we can only sell it to them. And there is no buyback arrangement can be done in the private environment.
Okay. Audience, please continue your questions. Okay, what is the initial investment for 1 acre plantation?
1 acre, we have to plant up to 250 plants, and each plant cost minimum 20 rupees to 35 rupees, and the other expenses are the manures and other things. I think it will take 1 lakh to, you know, initially, approximately 1 lakh.
Okay. Mr. Sandeep?
Another question?
Yeah. Is it legal? Yeah. Is it legal to sell or grow sandalwood? Does government permit this?
It is legal to grow the sandalwood without any permission by the government, from the government. And selling, we have to sell only to the government agencies. We cannot sell it to the outside market. Government permits to plant the sandalwood.
Okay.
And for the South Indian government has released the rule in 2002 so that everyone can plant in their farms. And North India, there is no specific rule whether they can plant or not, so that it is open, they can plant the sandalwood.
Okay. Okay. The price will be fixed by government?
Price is fixed by the government based on the market, international market. The hardwood is price is ranging from 6,000 to 7,000 as of now per kg.
Okay.
Yeah, it is a selling price. Selling price for hardwood is 6,000 to 7,000 rupees. In 15 years, one tree will generate 25 kg of hardwood. The total revenue after 15 years would be per acre 1.5 crores minimum.
Okay. Audience, please ask your questions. Mr. Sandeep, Brijesh, Devan Patel, Mohinder Singh. Okay, what are the suitable climatic conditions?
It can grow in a temperature between 30 to 42 degrees centigrade, and the dry climate is very suitable, but it needs a water for the first 5 years.
Okay.
It grows all over all the states in India.
Okay.
Except black cotton soil.
Okay. Okay, and what are the host plants planted with sandal?
First plant is Melia dubia, you know Melia dubia?
Okay,
and,
yeah.
One second. Melia dubia, red sander, rosewood, amla. The amla is a very good plant for intercropping so that they can get a revenue annual basis. This red sand, Melia dubia, they can get a return after 7 years. Red sander and rosewood, they can get return on after only 25 years. Amla, they can get return after 2 to 4 years, and every year they will get revenue from amla. Amla is very suitable for sandalwood.
Okay. Okay, and can we do intercropping with sandalwood plantation? If yes, which will be the suitable crop for intercropping?
Amla is suitable, and other vegetables also can be done, but when you plant the vegetables, and the important will go to the vegetables, so that the sandal will suffer. So the intercropping has to be as a amla. Amla is okay for intercropping if they want a revenue on annual basis.
Okay. And Mr. Sandeep is asking, he is based in Hyderabad and has a land of 50 acres. Is the climate around it's fine?
Yeah, Hyderabad area is very good for sandalwood planting, and it can be planted on 50 acres, no issues. Hyderabad, many people are doing in Hyderabad area.
Okay.
The climate condition in Hyderabad is very good for the sandal.
Okay. Audience? Please ask further questions. Okay. Plan for sandalwood is as border trees. Can I see any specific plots in and around the Hyderabad? Mr. Sandeep is asking.
Yeah, it can be done as a border trees, but we need to plant the horse tree nearby.
Okay. And Mr. Kumar is asking, are there any states in eastern or northern India where sandalwood is grown currently?
Sandalwood is grown currently, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. There are many places. There are many places in Karnataka. They grown for 20 acres, 30 acres, and it can be planted in mango plantations, in between mango plantation, in between coconut plantation. It can be planted in between the pomegranate. They have a pomegranate plant, in between they plant this sandalwood. The pomegranate act as a host tree.
Okay. Mr. Sandeep needs
any information?
Mr. Sandeep needs further information on in Hyderabad. Such a plot in and around Hyderabad.
He need more information on the border cropping.
Yeah, right.
Border cropping, they can plant in one sandalwood, and after that Melia dubia or teak or red sandal, between 16 feet away.
Okay. Mr. Brijesh is asking, is Kerala climate suitable for sandalwood?
Most of the climates are suitable, that 30 to 40 degree centigrade, and the dry conditions is okay, but we need to water for the first 5 years. Kerala climate condition is very good.
Okay, Mr. Sandeep has joined.
Kerala, Marayur area.
Okay, please continue.
In Kerala, the Marayur area, there are lot of sandalwood trees. So Kerala is very good for sandalwood, no issues.
Okay, Mr. Sandeep says he has joined a little late. He would like to know the basics like phosphor tree, variety, life and yield per tree.
The cost per tree would be around, we can say, 100 rupees to plant, including the plant cost of 20 rupees, and the pit for 2 feet depth, making a pit for 2 feet depth, and manure, and mixing the red soil and the other nutrition, everything. Per plant it may take 100 rupees. And the variety is, in India there is only one variety of sandal, no more varieties. That is called Sandalum album, scientific name. So in worldwide, the Sandalum album is the popular. Hello?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Do you hear me? Sandalum album is the only variety available in India. This is a very good variety, internationally accepted than any other varieties available in Australia and Indonesia. Our Indian Sandalum album is the very best variety. The life can be 15 years can be harvested, and it can be harvested in after 15 years, 30 years, 40 years. and they will get more return after that. Yield per tree after 15 years, there will be 25 kg of hard work. Each kg cost around 6,000 rupees to 7,000 rupees currently in the international market. And the sapwood around 50 kg, that is, that can be sold for 1,200 rupees. So, in 1 year after 1 acre after 15 years, we can get minimum 1.5 crores.
Okay. Mr. Prashant is asking what measures can be taken for not getting smuggled when ready for cutting.
What measure can be taken for not getting
smuggled when ready for cutting?
So that is depends. If you are planting for 15 acres, there are few measures can be taken for stopping the smuggling. Is one of the main thing is the solar fencing that can stop to some level. And you can put a private security with guns or arms, some whatever it is. You can grow dogs on it. Apart from that, there are the electronic devices available in the market, which can scan a particular area and find out if there is any human movement or anything, and give alarm or send SMS to your phone. Those things can be done. So those things can be taken after 7 years. Up to 7 years. There will not be any smuggling because there is no hardwood formed in the plant.
Okay. And Mr. Sandeep, yeah. Okay. Mr. Sandeep is asking, please give the economics costing per tree for 15 years to revenues, rough estimation. He did say rough estimation. Hello?
Cost estimation. Cost estimation?
Rough estimation.
Initially to plant a tree, other than the, if you want watering and bore well and drip irrigation, those costs we don't estimate because we assume that are already exist. And we assume only the planting cost will take 1 acre, 1 lakh rupees, including the plant cost and manure, with everything. And every year there will be maintenance of cutting the branches, and those maintenance will be there maybe yearly 5,000 to 10,000 rupees, and those are the costing. In 15 years there may be the expenses of up to 7 to 10 lakhs and the revenue will be 1.5 crores.
Okay. Okay. Do you provide sandalwood seed for planting materials?
We can provide sandalwood seeds. We can provide sandalwood saplings, and I think the manure, everything we can guide them where to get and what kind of manure they have to put, everything.
Okay. Okay. Mr. Sandeep continues with his discussion. He says 10 lakh of investment giving returns of 1.5 crores. That's really okay.
Yeah, that is strange in the sandalwood because of the cost. If you take other teak and other plantation, they are giving very less returns. But the sandalwood is per kg, is more or less is equivalent to the gold. That is what the current market situation is. After 15-20 years, there may be a price down. There may be expected some price down. Is because many people started planning, so that price may come down, and it will not go that much down.
Okay. Mr. Pandizura, you can type your email address. You can type your email address. Mr. Pandira, it's coming to me only. Please try to audience.
It's coming to you.
Yeah. Select all audience. Then you will go. Select all audience.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, we got it.
Okay.
Okay, Mr. Sandeep has question. Twenty-five kgs into 6,000 per kg. How does it give to 1.5 crores?
Let me check.
Mr. Kajendra is asking, is there any other use of sandalwood other than hardwood?
Sandalwood is there. Sandalwood will be around 50 kgs per tree, minimum 50 kgs per tree. Each kg is 50,000 rupees. Each kg is 12,200 rupees.
Okay.
So the answer to 1.5 crore is each plant can generate 25 kg. 1 acre we have 260 trees. 260 trees into 25 kgs.
Okay, Mr. Sandeep, I hope your question is answered.
Apart from that, each tree generate 50 kg of sapwood, that is 50,000 rupees per tree.
Okay. Mr. Kajendra, if you have any further questions, you can ask. Mr. Brijesh, Dr. Malik, Kajendra, Devan Patil, please ask your questions. Mr. Kumar. Okay, Mr. Sandeep says, that's like 3.9 crores just considering hardwood. Mr. Sandeep, would you like to speak on a, would you like to talk on mic? I'll unmute you. So that your calculations are correct.
I think the calculation comes to 54 lakhs per acre. And you know, this 25 kg is approximately is being told, some trees can generate more.
Kavita has question, what are the advantages of doing sandalwood plantations?
Sandal plantation giving the more returns on long run. That is the most important thing. And like other plantations, like tree, paddy, and every year you plant, you should have a lot of maintenance cost and the labor problem. Those things are there. Once it is planted for one or 2 years, you should have a maintenance. Then it will grow on its own. So that is very important. Those who have a lot of money and they can plant this. This revenue, I will let you know exactly what can be the revenue after 15 years.
Okay. And what are the special features of sandalwood seeds and seedlings sold by your organization?
What are the
special features?
The sandalwood seeds that we sell is collected from the government sources in the forest, and it is already depulped one, so that it will give a very good germination, and it was collected within last 2 months. So it gives minimum 65% germination. It was collected from 36 years old trees, so that it give more germination and it give more healthy plants. So these are the important features of our seeds.
Okay.
Some private parties will be selling the sandalwood seeds, which is collected from 4 year, 5 year old trees. So it's not that healthy plant is related.
Okay. And what is the best time to plant?
Best time? The best time in Tamil Nadu is June. June, July, August. In most of the South Indian states like Kerala, Karnataka, Andhra, this is the best time. In North India, that people may know which is not too hot and lightly climate condition is very good. So in that time they can plant. And in case this can be planted in all over the year except the very rainy seasons or those times.
Okay. Okay, Mr. Sandeep is asking, can it be grown organically or NPM based?
Yes. It can be grown organically. Means there are Jeeva Mrdam can be supplied every month, so that you don't have to supply any artificial fertilizers. And using a Jeeva Mrdam, it will grow very, very well. And the VAM can be put when it is planted in the field, 20 grams of VAM can be put and the plant will respond very well for the VAM. And the NPM, I am not very aware of NPM based.
Kavita,
there are 17 varieties of sandalwood.
What are the different varieties of sandalwood seedlings form? How can one decide which sandalwood seed and seedling variety is good for cultivation?
So there are 17 sandalwood seedlings out there, and in which in India we get only one sandalwood seedling. There is no different variety of sandalwood seedling. Our Indian sandalwood seedling is Sandalum album,